You don't want to necessarily say, hi, I'm going to turn in my free and reduced lunch card. Some of the ideas that we talked about that I've seen work is where you ask every person in the school to fill it out. First of all, it's good to have that information, address, phone number for students anyway, because it's a place to keep it. But that way you take away the stigma of someone, especially the older students. And so that's one thing we're looking at. We also are looking at, in the computer system, if there are siblings that have already turned in the card, you can transfer that up so you don't have to collect the card, because collecting it is a cost. So we're exploring many different options, but we right now are between 12 to 1,500 students, about a high school, the size of this, short of meeting that goal. But I believe that there are many students that have not identified themselves quite yet that we can still look for and find. Oh, I'm sorry, Patty. You can also signal.
So when it comes to question, I don't know.
I'll repeat the question.
Can you use the mic?
They can use the mic up there, yeah. Okay. The question that was just asked, the question just asked was, how much more do you get when you go up to the 55%? It's sizable, you know. I probably have to say it's probably very close to the supplemental on top.
It's an additional 50% of the base for all the students above the 55%.
It's an additional 15%. And so the fact that we have districts such as Mount Diablo that are stuck in that middle, is especially large districts stuck in the middle, is something really to continue with our conversation as community members. Because if you have a school with 33,000 kids, you know at least 16,000 should be receiving that. So we have 16,000 students who are not receiving that bonus that they would otherwise. So the funding formula, in my humble opinion, is flawed, because it really should be by school. Because if you're looking at a concentration and all of the impact of concentration, you would have that at a school.
Right now, it's being done from the district.
What caused the district? Oh, not the conference. See what I'm saying? Okay. So, to move forward, I want you to see this. You have it in your PowerPoint, and it's something to separate. And this is where also we have some disconnects between the state and the federal government. And they're not quite agreeing with each other yet. I shouldn't say yet. They're not agreeing with each other. I don't know if that will ever happen. But transportation is a requirement of some of our money federally. So it's going to be continued in a separate process. The question was, where does special education fit in? This was a conversation that was that we had today at Cabinet. And so special education and English learners, currently those two strong student support groups are developing how they will address Common Core. So nothing is really final in those areas. But special education funding will be a federally funded program. So the federal government will continue to fund special education. And so in this, the answer is, we're not visible in the way I believe that we need to see them visible in this picture. And I think it's another question. It's kind of like the middle school students. If we have students who have special needs, how are we going to address that with what we have? So excellent question, because I believe part of local control, when we get responsibility, we are often given tough decisions. And this is one of them. I believe that local control is sometimes a way for central control to go, I don't want to have to think about that.
Because if we're only getting funding from the feds, I mean, they don't fund the mandate 100%, so we're still going to be cutting out bases to fund the land fund.
Yes, absolutely. And it's very similar to the middle school, because we will look at low income, foster youth, and you know, high percentage are special needs students, and then fewer English learners. But that supplemental money, which is going up, we'll also need to consider all of our students who are any questions on this? This is something you might want to revisit and look at. Questions just over here from the gentleman in the front. Oh, I thought you were
I was just going to add one more thing about special education. AB 602 funding is still outside of the LCFF. So there's a piece of state funding that's outside of all of this related to special education. That hasn't changed.
That the state wants us to look at. And I'll go through and give you the broad category.